Ladies and gentlemen, today is a day we are waiting for. Let me, on behalf of members of the Campaign Council, accept to head this Campaign Council and to make sure that PDP wins election on September 19, 2020. Let me say clearly that the terms of reference is very clear, that we should make sure that the results, according to the will of the people, is delivered. I want to assure you that by the grace of God, nothing will stop us from victory. Nothing will stop us from victory. Let me say that. Commend the aspirants for accepting to work together. And that is why today our candidate is having sleepless, is not having sleepless nights. He cannot rest well, no litigation, no nothing. And that's what is expected of a party, of an opposition party. And I urge the leadership of this party to make sure we have the same thing in Ondo State, so that Ondo will win the kit of PDP come October. Mr. Chairman, you know I will always say the truth and nothing but the truth. Nobody can intimidate us for this election. Nobody can intimidate us for this election. Yesterday, I was told, and today I read on pages of newspaper, that one governor of a kind of state, Dayasu, he said is a Ganduji. He said he was going to isolate me until the election is over. That tells you, if Nigeria is supposed to be a country, who is supposed to be isolated? Who is supposed to be isolated? A man who pockets dollars in his Bavaria from contractors is not isolated, and you say me will be isolated. You see, that's why I say this country, where are we heading to? Look at me. I'm somebody who pulls dollars from left, right, is a bad guy, from contractor, is saying that I will be isolated. Let me assure you, why the American DJ, the chairman of the Campaign Council, is because of the dollar they saw. It's because of the dollar. But for the dollar, Gandhiji would not have been made the chairman of the Campaign Council. But what they don't understand, that we, from the Niger Delta, will chop the dollar and will chop him into a coma. So, Gandhiji, your dollar will not work in a those states. So, we have integrity in our party. How did we lose the election in Edo State? We didn't know the candidate we had. Had a lot of problems. And that was why the people of Edo State listened to Shemori at that time. But you can see a party that has no principle. A man that is said made another person to lose his manhood. I didn't say so. Osimhole said so. I never said so. Osimhole said so. So, SDMU, I didn't say so. It is Osimhole that said you put acid on somebody's manhood. I didn't say so. It was Simon that said so. And again, to tell you that this government, you can never ever trust them. And they said the chairman of the Presidential Advisory Committee on Corruption was the chairman of the panel that indicted their so-called candidate now. Professor Issa Iyage, can you speak up? Were you the chairman then that indicted his candidate? Professor Issa Iyage, where are you? Speak up now. Speak up now. Tell Nigerians whether you are the one who indicted him or not. Osimhen said, this man called himself a pastor. It's unfortunate, how can they make him a pastor? That the man is a terrible liar. Osimhen, did he say so or not? Osimhen, did he say so or not? Osimhen, answer me. The time to answer me has come. So, they know they have no candidate. But let us understand the statement made by Ganduje. It's not just, don't look at things ordinary. What Ganduje said is that they have concluded with the security agencies to make sure the people of Edo State do not protect and defend their votes, that they will not allow them to come out before they know it, that they have announced the result. So he just used me to say they would isolate me. No, I'm not at his level. He knows I'm not at his level. So he just used that to cover. What he was telling Nigerians is that, look, this election will make sure if those people, they don't come out to vote, even if they vote, will not allow them to protect and defend their vote. So, Edo people, now they have told you they will not allow you to vote. Even if you vote, they will not allow you to protect and defend your vote. It's a direct challenge to all of you, the leaders here from Edo State. It is not a direct challenge. Because we, members of the campaign council, we cannot vote. Because we are not registered to vote in Edo. But I can tell you, candidates should not think the way they read that Kwakwan said and they will do that in Edo State. No, it will not happen. The way they use security to rig up Kwakwan said, it will not happen in Edo State. It will not happen. Because people want in Kano State and we know what happened. So if he thinks that is what they can do, far, 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 far. And security agencies, my business is to expose you to the world. Any attempt to rig this election in Edo State, then we will know whether it is better for us to remain here or not. Because Edo people have spoken. Edo people have spoken, and it is very, very clear. So let nobody make any attempt. You can rig any other place. Edo State has come back to PDP. Since 1999, Edo State has been PDP. I don't know what happened to PDP. That's it to, I don't know what they called it. Now that we have taken our state back. And let me assure my brother, the governor, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. You're a governor. Don't be afraid. Stand firm. This election will win it. And win it very, very well. So, Mr. Chairman, let me tell you that we have already started work. Unknown, even before the inauguration, I spoke to the governor the other day. I told him one or two things. And I said, we cannot fold our hands. If they don't do that, if we have to go home. Everybody go home. Everybody go home. Don't approach the game from Abuja. Go home. Because this election is the final. If we don't win a day, this time around, chairman, all these things, leader, no. They must win this election. This one, they have the governor now, so they must win this election. So, Chief Dobesi, Chief Tabikimi, all of you, former Minister of Works, everybody now. go home. And let us work to make sure that Godwin Obaseki is returned. It's a challenge. It's a challenge. If a man at the age of 100 years, like Ganduje, of course, you know, it's not less than 100 years. By the fact I have, I took from my INEC, it's not less than 100 years. So if a man of 100 years is feeling that he can challenge people who, according to him, said he has a war veteran, people like Yahya Bello, what they will see? What they will see? We're not like Dino Milani. They can do anyhow. We're not like Dino Milani. They know where we are coming from. Nobody will take Edo State from us. So, Mr. Chairman, you and members of the National Working Committee, go home and relax. The work has started. PDP, this is the first time you are starting up a national council campaign of other states. This is the first time you will win too. You have never won before. This one, I will dash it to you, you will win. Everything we will do to win. So, you know, I'm not an Abuja man, and I hardly come here. So, but I said I must come today to tell you that we will win this election. We will win this election. In fact, I'm not sure they told Buhari about their candidate. Because if they told Buhari, I'm not sure Buhari would have accepted. They didn't tell him the truth. Frankly speaking, if Buhari knew about the facts of this, their candidate, Buhari wouldn't have accepted. But now that I have told him, I'm sure he will have a rethink. He will say, look, there's no need. Obaseki, we shall allow him to go back. Because from all records, according to them, according to Shimole, Obaseki is the man who will turn Edo State. Is it not? So, the whole thing is clear, it's over. But we'll give them whatever they want. We will give them whatever they want. We are peaceful people, but don't come and rig our election. Don't touch this seed that God has given to us. This one, God gave to us. I'm not the one who caused their problem that made our brother to come back. We will not lose him. So we will still continue to make sure Edo State remains in PDP. So I thank you very much and believe that the whole world should hear that this election is whether Nigeria want to stand in democracy, whether Nigeria want to go back to dictatorship. But this election, and I believe Buhari in this one, he wants to do one man, one vote. You know, he has promised, and I believe him, that he will do one man, one vote. So I thank you, and I believe that members of the committee will sit back for 10 minutes to have the inaugural meeting, then from there we'll take off. But rest assured that we'll do everything to make sure that PDP wins. When they heard my name, they were all shaking. They should shake because they know what will happen to all of them. Thank you, and God bless all of you.
Thank you, sir. PDP, power to the people. Indeed, we win Edo State according to the newly inaugurated chairman of the committee of Edo 2020. His deputy is the governor of Adamawa State,